Hello, I'm Igor Arregui from ASTI. I will show you what we learned from methods for estimating fish tracks using AUTTP electronic tagging data. So we need to deal with light geolocation and the uncertainty related. This uncertainty increases with sun declination, higher latitudinally and higher when approaching to equinoxes, and very important uncertainty due to light intensity estimation at surface that increases with depth and low water transparencies. So high number of sources of uncertainty that we can see here for a big eight tuna with deep distribution in an area of upwelling, so low transparencies that give us geolocation with high uncertitude, and then we need to keep out the outliers as we see in the right panel. The track estimation to overcome and filter those uncertainties relies on the model and fitting parameters, as the sun declination error can be modeled and fish movement also. And we can also fit the data temperatures from the fish with external fields as sea surface temperature or profiles of depth and temperature PDTs. Other constraints, land and bathymetry, obviously can be used. The method, is hidden Markov model, but for MiniPad is implemented in Global Position Estimator 3 using SST. This is a black box, but very popular recently for the internal archival tags from LOTEC. We use the hidden Markov model from Brown that's can incorporate other fields as PDTs because it's open and is open and everything is reproducible. Fish movement dynamic in this case is maximum speed and the constraint bathymetry. The results are equivalent with both methods, and overcoming the uncertainty to estimate the tracks, SST fields need to be with high trends, high gradients, which is not met in equatorial area or Western African upwelling because it's parallel to the longitude. A recovery position is useful also. In this second example, we see how a yellowfin in an equatorial area with homogeneous SST fields in the top left panel led us a broad daily likelihood, and then the entire track is uncertain. While using PDTs, the likelihoods are very constrained and the track is precise. If we have a complex behavior, as this yellowfin in South Africa with two cycling migrations to Indian Ocean, the results are inconsistent, and then we need to try different fitting parameters to obtain in the left bottom panel a correct and consistent result compared with the raw geolocation, but also with PDT, which is more precise. So, recommendations are reviewing each step involved in the track estimation process, everything. Rejection of outliers, compare the results from PDT and SST fields, compare the track with the raw geolocation for consistency, this is very important, and try different modeling fitting parameters to obtain robust results. Take into account that modeled PDTs might not be realistic and or too constraining, and then can let us fitting problems and convergence problems. Thank you.